Morning students, today we are going to solve remaining problems in exercise 13.2, fifth problem. See what is given in the question. A vessel is in the form of an inverted cone. What is inverted cone? The reverse of the cone. See here, I'll draw one figure. This is the inverted cone. And its height is given. What is the height of the cone? 8 cm. So I am taking height of the cone as h, denoting it by h, h equal to 8 cm. And the radius of its top. Its top is in the form of circle. Its radius is given, that is 5 cm. So I am taking radius as 5 cm. Okay, 5 cm is the radius of top of the cone. It is filled with water. So this cone is totally filled with full of water up to the brim. When lead shots each of which is sphere of radius 0.5. So we have some lead shots which are in the form of sphere and its radius is given. So that radius I am taking as R1 is 0.5, which is the radius of the lead shot, each lead shot. So we are dropping this lead shots into the inverted cone, into the vessel. Then 1/4 of the water flows out. 1/4 of the water flows out from the vessel. When we are dropping the lead shots into the vessel, so 1/4 of the water will be flows out. Then find the number of lead shots dropped into the vessel. So how many lead shots if you drop in the vessel, then 1/4 of the water flows out. So we are going to find number of lead shots to drop into the vessel to flows out 1/4 of the water from the vessel. Okay, this is the question. So I wrote the given information here. Let me solve this. Okay, let me solve this problem. See, we have inverted cone. It is full of water. It is filled with full of water. When lead shots, some number of lead shots we are dropping into the vessel. So I am taking these number of lead shots as number of lead shots, n lead shots I am dropping into the vessel. Then water flows out. How much water flows out? 1/4 of the volume of cone. Okay, 1/4 of the water will flows out when n number of lead shots dropped into the vessel. So here we are finding how many lead shots you have to drop into the vessel. That is equal to 1/4 of the water which is flows out. Okay, right. Solution. See here, I am writing the given information. Given height of the cone. H equal to 8 cm. This is height of the cone. Radius of the cone. Radius of the cone means it is top radius. Radius of the cone I am taking as r equal to 5 cm. Next, lead shot radius. Each lead shot radius. I am taking as r1. R1 is 0.5 cm. Okay, right. Now I am considering number of lead shots. I am going to take number of lead shots as n. If n lead shots are dropped into the vessel, then 1/4 of the water will be flows out. Okay, let n number of lead shots were dropped. Dropped into the vessel. The number of lead shots are n. N number of lead shots we are dropping into the vessel. Then 1/4 of the water from the cone flows out. Okay. So I considered number of lead shots as n. Okay. I assumed as n number of lead shots we are dropping into the vessel. Then that is equal to volume of the water, 1/4 of the volume of the water from the cone is flows out. Okay. So how we can find now number of lead shots? 1/4 of the water. 1 by 4 volume of core. Volume of core. 1 by 4 volume of core means the water quantity which is flows out. Volume of quantity 1 by 4 volume of quantity which is flows out from the vessel is equal to what? It is equal to n into volume of n into volume of each lead shaft. Each lead shaft. Volume of each lead shaft. Lead shaft. So what is the volume of cone? 1 by 4. 1 by 3. Pi r square h is volume of cone equal to n into sphere value. 4 by 3. Pi r 1 cube. Why? Because r1 is the radius of the lead shaft. And r is the radius of the core. Both are different. So that's why I am denoting here r, here r1. Okay. We are going to find this n, number of lead shafts. Okay. Right. Here 1 by 2 is pi. R square value is, r square is what? Pi. Pi square into h value 8 is equal to n into 4 by 3 pi r1 0.5. whole cube. 0.5 whole cube. Pi, pi cancel on both sides. Okay. Now 25 into 8 by 12 into by sending 3 by 4, 4 by 3 at the left hand side, we'll get 3 by 4. And sending 0.5 whole cube at left hand side, we'll get 1 by 0.5 whole cube. Is equal to what? N. Okay. Let me simplify this. N equal to here 3 4s are. So 25 into 8 12, 4 2s are. 25 into 2 again we can cut it 2 and 2 2s are. 25 by 2 into I'm expanding this 0.5 means it is 5 by 10 so 10 cube by 5 cube 10 cube by 5 cube so 25 5 square cancel. So 10 cube is 1000. 1000 by 2 5 is 10. 0 0 cancel. N equal to 100. So how many lead shafts we have to drop into the vessel? How many lead shafts we have to drop into the vessel? 100 lead shafts we have to drop into the vessel to get 1 by 4th of the water flows out. Okay. So therefore, number of lead shafts to drop into the vessel. Drop lead shaft dropped into the vessel into the vessel is equal to 100. So we need 100 lead shafts to drop into the vessel to get 1 by 4th of the water flows out from the vessel. Okay. Now question number 6. See what is given in the question. A solid iron pole. A solid iron pole consists of cylinder of height 220 centimeters. A solid iron pole consists of cylinder of height 220 centimeters and base diameter 24 centimeters. So I am drawing the figure according to question. So a pole consists of cylinder of height 220 centimeters. Okay, 220 centimeters. I have taken one cylinder whose height is 220 centimeters and base diameter 24 centimeters. This is the base diameter is 24 centimeters, which is surmounted by a cylinder of height 60 centimeter. So upon this cylinder we have another cylinder, smaller cylinder, whose height is 60 centimeters. See, whose height is 60 centimeter and radius top or bottom, radius, not diameter, radius. So here we have diameter, but for the smaller cylinder we have the radius. Radius is 8 centimeters. Now this is the pole. It consists two cylinders. One is smaller cylinder, another one is larger cylinder. This is the pole, this which contains two cylinders. One is larger cylinder, another one is smaller cylinder. Smaller cylinder is surmounted on the larger cylinder. So here we are going to find the mass of the pole. We are going to find total mass of the pole, and given that 1 centimeter cube volume iron has approximately 8 grams of mass. So we have to find total volume of the pole. After getting total volume of the pole, 1 centimeter cube volume is equal to 8 gram mass. 1 centimeter cube volume will give 8 gram mass. Then total volume into 8 grams will give the total pole mass. Okay. Now I will write the given information here. Solution. See how I am going to solve solution. Given. First I will write the dimensions of larger cylinder. Height of larger cylinder. Height of the larger cylinder, I am denoting by H1, 220 centimeters. Next, radius of larger cylinder. Radius of larger cylinder, I am denoting by R1. R1 is 24. Sorry, this is diameter, no? So we have the diameter first given. Diameter of larger cylinder is equal to 24 centimeters. Then radius. I am denoting radius by R1. R1 equal to 24 by 2, that is 12 centimeters. Okay, next. Smaller cylinder dimensions. Height of smaller cylinder. Height of smaller cylinder, I'm denoting by H2. H2 is 60 centimeters. And already we have the radius. Radius is given. Radius of smaller cylinder. Radius of smaller cylinder, I am denoting by R2, which is 8 centimeters. These are the given dimensions. Okay. Now I am going to find total pole volume. Volume of pole. How to get volume of pole? Volume of larger cylinder. Plus volume of smaller cylinder. Volume of larger cylinder formula. What is the volume of cylinder? Pi R square H. But larger cylinder dimensions are R1, H1. Okay. Next, plus volume of smaller cylinder, pi R2 square H2. Okay. Right. Now I am going to substitute the values. I am taking pi common, R1 square H1, R2 square H2. Right, pi into, I am going to substitute the given values. R1, what is R1? 12 centimeter. 12 square into H1, 220. Plus 220. R2 square, 8 square. H2 67. Now pi 144 into 220 64 into 60. 144 into 220, 64 into 60. 64 into 60. 6 4s are 24, 2, 6 6 are 36, 38. So here 3840. Next 144 into 220. 0 0 0 with 0. 2 4 the 8, 2 4 the 8, 2 1 the 2 4 the 8, 2 4 the 8, 2 1 the 0, 8, 16, 1, 11, 1, 3. So here 3, 1, 6, 8, 0. Into pi value 22 by 7. So by simplifying this, after simplifying this, here 3, 1, 6, 8, 0. 3, 3, 8, 4, 0. 0, 12, 1. 14, 15, 1, 5, so 22 by 7 into 3, 5, 5, 2, 0. So after simplifying this, you will get 1,11,532.8 cm³. This is the volume of the hole. Okay. This is the volume of the hole, but we are going to find mass of the hole. Okay. Given. What is given in the question? Given 1 cm³ is equal to 8 grams of mass. We have how many centimeters cube? 1,11,532. So therefore mass of the pole. How to get mass of the pole? 1,11,532.8 into 8 grams. So multiplying with 8, you will get, after multiplying with 8, you will get 8,92,862.4 grams. So 8,92,262.4 grams. If you convert into kgs, it will be equal to 892.262 kgs of mass. I converted grams into kgs by dividing by 1000. Okay, if you dividing by 1000, the point will be shifted to left hand side 3 digits. So you will get 892 kgs approximately. 892 kgs is the mass of the hole. Okay.